Hey guys, your Broker Viz, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Braga career mode. Well, still left off. I start off the career mode, of course. After finishing the Juventus career mode, I've now moved to Portugal SC Braga. This is the third game in the league. I won the first two games being Benfica and Real Avu. Ooh, I probably said that wrong again, but whatever. It's not like I was expecting to get the pronunciations right. I'm playing Arouca, and I'll also have a game against Boa Vista, but between that will be deadline day. I have no money. I spent pretty much all my Nicholas Sewell,
which I explained in the first episode. If you didn't see it, go back and watch it.
But yeah. And after the first episode, I sit pretty already top of the table. Normally, start off career mode, so I normally have to find a way to get past a team who's always before me. But as it is, I look to be the team who plays before my rivals, although my closest rivals, Sporting, which is ironic because I managed them last week, but I'm sure you guys remember, are in second place, and I've also won the first two games. And Carleo has scored two goals, so yeah, that'll be interesting when that match comes up. I looked, it's in December, which it's written, isn't it? It's almost every single FIFA secondary career mode I've done so far. In the Gladbach career mode, I faced Bayern and just remember looking to gain some advantage over them. I drew 0-0. You, this career mode, I played against Milan in December. I drew 0-0. Even in my Liverpool career mode, in the first season, I played Chelsea in December, and I drew 0-0. There is a very, very annoying trend developing here. And I will aim to, when I play Sporting in December, I will aim to not let that run continue. Even if I go all out attack, that match will not end 0-0. That is my goal for that match. But of course, hopefully, by then, I'll already be a few points ahead. Seriously, I will go all out attack. I don't care. I will risk losing the match before I let it end 0-0. Because it has to goddamn stop.
Not much in that. It was a whisker wide of the post.
Of course, I also won a game against Porto in December or so. That might be the game I have to go all out for. Or it depends on who's second at the time. Of course, I'm looking at Sporting it second now, but only two games have been played, so there's no reason that they could still Anyway, as I was saying, it's annoying.
There's no guarantee they'll be still second when I do play him. It might be Porto, it might be Benfica, which is, I wouldn't even have to worry, because I've already been in Benfica. I beat him in the last episode.
Blocked well by the defender.
And go back and watch that if you did not see that episode.
That's gone out for...
While you're at it, smash the like button and subscribe. Do all the stuff. Do all the normal YouTube standard procedure, you know the drill. these guys are actually undefeated in their first two games as well, so I can't take them lightly. Because they've scored the first goal against me in ages. Like, I'm struck because I didn't concede at all in my Juventus career mode.
He's coming forward.
He's in the lead, so. Okay, that one, because I can see it. Goal now is to get the second goal and go on to win this match. And that won't help. Who was that? That was a terrible header.
I've got the ball in the middle of the pitch.
See. Traore. Going right back. See.
Offside is the call. We can see it again, which of course the officials can't.
No, they get one chance.
Of course you're offside. Why wouldn't you be? Let's go. To the man.
And here comes the counter.
Well, pass. Traore. Yes! 2-1. Traore scores again. He's been banging him. Score a few goals in the first steps, both like I said, and he's continued that run and got on the end of the pass and put it home.
Very well taken.
Narrowly, but he did put it away, so there's that. Is a fourth goal already in the league.
We start the game 2-1.
Just see if I can't get another goal. Thus, Traore again.
Right side!
And put it back for 2 minutes. It's 3-1 anyway. I think it's Hansen. We're only his second goal of the season. In fact, it's 2 in 2 games because he scored his first in the last match.
Well, you've got to ask questions to the defense because they just didn't follow.
Oh, that wasn't even 2 minutes. I was expecting it to be 2 minutes. I think it was a gust though. Oh, granted to the box. I'm used to that being 2 minutes in a Liverpool crumb. You see him running into the box to see if he can't get on a loose ball. That's actually nice to see that Augusto does that as well, so that's going to be a big help. I'm not used to playing 4-4-2, I can't remember the last time I did. I decided when I saw that they went, that Braga play 4-4-2, I was like, you know what? Screw it. Let's go for it. Freaking YOLO. And Sporting are winning. Brilliant. It is going to be Sporting, isn't it?
He's got that through clever
put some distance in between me and them. Hansen scores again. Hansen getting his finally in the spotlight. In the first episode, I'm not very happy with Hansen, despite the fact they did score one goal. But this is much better. But this is what you'd expect from. Well, I want to say he's the main striker. I guess he is, because Traore was brought in by me, so. Hansen was already here. I didn't even know who he was until I saw it. Like, To be fair, I still don't know who he is. It's a random guy.
Koulibaly.
Yeah. He was always, he was one of their highest rated players. When I got here, and obviously, he is important to the team.
It's confirmed this deal is done. Well, we're here in around £4 to £5 million, and for that kind of money, the fans will be expecting something pretty decent. And he's moved in, trying to jostle the opponent off his stride. Koulibaly.
It's a massive try from the half time.
To dig the ball into a teammate like that.
At one point it was 1-1, and now it's 4.
Any touch, the opposition can take the ball away.
Traore is going to get that.
It's a useful ball in.
Ah, and the cross is blocked.
And a corner to come via that deflection. Well, we've got a winger coming off here, Alan. Not a winger who's played very well, to be honest with you.
No, he hasn't, and I just wonder whether they're going to play with a bit less width now, because it hasn't worked. Been up against a top quality fullback, and there's nothing come from that.
Someone went down not very awkwardly for
if I just get a good connection here, I'm going to score, and he was right.
Simon went down very awkwardly for Ronaldo. Two men.
He's a tough guy, I think he'll carry on.
Traore. Oof.
The home side want to make.
Now, play it to throw me. Are they going to bring that guy off?
Substitution is going to happen now.
Yeah. You can't risk it, mate. People are thinking of a bigger picture. Your health.
Got his shot off now. Managed to stop the ball going forward with that block.
Rafa!
Fantastic goal.
Player who is very important is what the Moscow career model FIFA 14, sorry, has finally got his first goal of the season.
Reflected in the scoreline.
I think it's going to be a
very scrappy goal, but they all count.
Well in the lead.
Yeah. That will start finally off the mark for Rafa, player who I used. Who I enjoy using immensely. The first part of that Moscow shirt, as you saw that career mode, will remember. Yes! Oh, yes! 6? No, I think it's Traore. Yes, it is. Not sure how I managed to squeeze that in.
That was audacious, wasn't it, in the extreme? To try the shot from that kind of tight angle. Absolutely brilliant.
Let's take another look at
a player who was trying to keep it up. Or should consider himself lucky that it crossed the line before he got to it, because if he had touched it and it had gone in, then it would have been an own goal. So yeah, and, I mentioned that this team was 2 for 2. I'm not going to go for 3 for 3.
They've got it back by an interception. Here's an opportunity, maybe.
Demand Santos 7-1. Already racking up. It's probably going to be one of the biggest, if not the biggest, win of the season. In only the third match. All of a sudden, we've gone from playing legendary to fucking amateur. Not sure how I managed that. Then again, I'm pretty good at making legendary look like amateur.
Free kick.
Hey, if I was one, why not? Why the hell not?
Traore.
I think I've earned the right to be a little cocky considering 7-1, but that was a bit ambitious. It's to say the very least. Santos. Traore. The defense have fallen asleep. 7-1 down, you think they'd be more alert, let alone not asleep. Foul. You can't win them all. Fair enough. Tim Evans loses the ball to pass. Not used to saying that about Tim Evans. He's usually very good with his passes. Bah. As in roll, brilliant passes, delivery and end product. No is the answer to that question. Ref may as well blow it now. Oh, hang on. Oh! Catastrophic defending. Lucky me that I didn't have more room there with Santos, or that would have been 8-1. There's the full time whistle, 7-1 is the margin. Now, the question is, did Sporting win? Please say they did. Damn it, they did! 2-1. Why do I get the feeling the team they were playing probably pulled it back and then they got a late winner? That would be just my luck, to be honest. I have no money to spend. Even if I did, I wouldn't have anything to improve. Granted, I can see a goal in that last game, but that was purely down to my he not paying attention. He's too focused on talking to you guys, which I'm not using as an excuse, I'm just saying I should have been paying more attention while I was talking to you. But that's my own bad. I'll take that on the chin. I'll improve for the next time. But yeah, I have no reason to spend. I don't think there's any part of the team I can prove. And I'm just praying that one of these four or office emails is not an injury. Scout, didn't send out a scout. Well, he's terrible, whoever he is. He's not exactly what I consider an amazing scouted player. Even though I didn't send out a scout. I didn't buy a few. Yeah, see? I didn't buy one. So I'm really confused where this came from. No idea who this guy is. No idea where I got him from, and no idea who gave him. I'm assuming maybe one of my PlayStation Network friends gave me a thing I just didn't notice. And I would have noticed. It's pretty terrible, whoever he is. You know what, let's train him up a bit. Maybe he can become a decent player, who knows, but 87 is his potential? Yeah. He's not gonna set the world on fire. I mean, he'll be a decent right back at 87. I mean, that's higher than any right back right now. And again, I haven't seen Dani Alves's rating. Well, he might have gone up, I don't know. He starts off as an 85, so very possible he could have gone up by two. And Diana was probably the... Oh wait, Philip Lahm. I guess it would depend on what you count Lahm as, because do you count him as a center defense in mid or a right back? Because he plays both. For whatever strange reason. I like him better as a right back, if you're asking me. I think Bayern have plenty of defensive midfielders, and Lahm does not need to fill that position. I mean, granted, if you want him to play that position, that's your property, but if it were up to me, he would play right back, and play only right back. So there's that. Anyway, let's get in. Ah, crap, I meant to check if Sporting were playing. Well, I guess I'll see at halftime.
This is the one we've been waiting for, we being Martin Tyler and Alan Smith in the commentary box, and you, of course, ready to watch the game unfold.
Yeah, I can't wait for this one.
See if I can get four wins from four.
Santos. This is the home team lineup.
It's a lot of balls.
I think it looks that way, Martin. Yes, it's the conventional shape. It's the one that the manager prefers.
It was a good idea to try and use the width on the pitch, but it's gone out for a throw. It's a decent cross, punched away by the goalkeeper. And shoots!
Wait, that was terrible. Confidence is high in the player.
Well, when he's on the ball, you know, he's as quick as anybody.
He got the opening goal in this game against Aurora. I realise again that I'm probably saying their name wrong.
Well done, the goalkeeper, and he's hung on to the ball.
What can you do?
Oh, the pitch not quite wide enough for him there.
Well, it was under no pressure, but he's giving me a throw anyway. Fair enough. Thank you. I guess. Interesting. Chris Jinmi. Team friend. Not back. It's actually Bolitio again. I'm probably saying his name wrong. Rignani. I don't know where I saw it.
He's moved in, trying to jostle the opponent off his stride. It's another turnover here. Routine for the keeper. Possession.
Timmons. Santos.
Elsewhere, Ala Bacanale.
It's a goal for Benfica.
Past the trial, right? Well, oh, that tells me Benfica are playing. But that's me. But I still don't know if Sporting are playing or not. Timmons!
And the goalkeeper got a touch to that. Fine save.
Boy, here's the keeper pulls off a big save. Skirmish sounds like... Well, skirmish is... I don't know, a word for a fight, isn't it?
almost tackled out of play there, that challenge.
Crap. That would have probably been a card as well. Oh, hey. You fouled it. So that was a double bad decision. One that I missed the slide tackle, and two that it would have been a bad challenge since my hat connected. It doesn't matter because Traore has scored his sixth goal in four games. And it's 1-0. Your things are going in and off with us, though. I mean, he was right there. I'm not sure how I missed it, to be fair. But, I'll take it. 1-0. Oh. And again, I say thank you, Chelsea.
He gets it back. That will help ease the pressure. They feel good about that. A really strong and clean tackle. And it's going to be his throw here.
Try him right again.
The break is definitely on.
Try him right, is he going to go all the way? Ooh, good save by the keeper. I will take the corner. Two man's. Can't see, it's probably offside anyway, to be fair. That's though. Traore. Santos. Traore!
So it's 1-0 here.
Now that is how you end the first half. That's pretty goddamn close.
That's a good performance, isn't it, Alan, from him in the first half?
Well, he played really well, didn't he? And he got himself a goal to put his team ahead. He'll be pleased with that first 45 minutes.
Now, the big question is, are Sporting playing? And if they are, what is their scoreline? They're 0-0. Come on, Nacional, yes. This Portuguese team who weirdly have a very similar crest to Manchester United. I don't know if you've seen it. It's very similar to Manchester United crest. It's kind of weird. But,
the keeper did well to get down to it.
Whether they are a ripoff for a discount version of United, I don't give a shit. As long as they keep 0-0. Well, if they're anything like Man United, 0-0 should come as a standard. As long as they don't pull a Thursday and go and let it be shooting practice for the other team as the other team wins 2-0. Come on, I had to get one. Hang on, who did he book? What? What did I do?
It's a little, I just gotta calm down.
Run into him. That is not a yellow card. Just ran into him. It's not my fault he was in the air.
Alan McAnally keeping us up to date as usual. Alright. That's a really important challenge. They would have been in.
Now I have to be super careful. And then Traore, yes, 2-0. But as I was saying, I had to get one in. Although, to be fair, the Liverpool Kermo video tomorrow is gonna be fucking full of me bragging about that. Because, well, it's winning against your rivals. If you don't brag, what's the fucking point of having rivals if you don't brag when you beat them? I mean, if it were Man United, if Man United had won, would Man United fans be bragging? You're damn right they would be. They think, oh, we're the best. No, you're not. You're terrible. Well, And coming from Liverpool, well, considering this is not exactly even in our best season, then that's saying something. If we're saying you're bad, then you fucked up.
It's a turnover in play.
Rafa. To the man's. Priori, who is on a hat trick. He's not gonna get it this time though. I press circle! Do you even respond, Hansen? Like, it took like 5 hours and he didn't even shoot. Hello? Yeah, where's his yellow card, huh? Where's his yellow card? Aw, you dumb motherfucker.
And just look at the club involved. It's Juventus who made this sign.
Yes, the very rare transfer of David Alaba to Juventus has happened. I mean, I would never have guessed that transfer might happen. Like, seriously. I thought EA fixed this. I said they fixed it. What did I do? What was I actually doing there? I should have really conceded there. That was idiotic.
Able to make a good interception.
Hansen, way! That was terrible, Hansen.
I want to see it again. I bet you do too.
Two occasions where you should have put it in easily or passed it off. Although the first one was definitely should have been your goal. All you have to do is put it in, and you did. Imagine Hayden is one and have a child. He's like, say, I'd like to get, have a child with children, but I don't know what to do. Do I put it in, or do I not put it in? Which is like, put it in. Okay. And he fucking misses. I don't know.
His teammates, they thought he'd scored there.
I'm so sorry. Oh, I shouldn't have said that, but I said it. I don't give a shit. I really don't. This is not like he's gonna fucking. I mean, it's not like he's gonna see this. Let's be honest. If he does, hey Hansen, work on your shooting, mate. And work on your positioning. And your finishing. Your finishing's not exactly the best thing. Oh, what am I even talking about? What'd be eating there? It'd be weird if he was like a homosexual. He wasn't even married.
Great day.
Which is possible, I mean no. So that's your I can't tell people what to do. Ooh, I mean, I've no problem with any of that stuff, but there I am assuming he's married. And yes, Nacional have pulled a 0-0. They are the Manchester United of the Portuguese League. They're the masters of 0-0. Yeah! And now I'm 2 points clear at the top of the table! Woo! Yeah! So all in all, a very productive episode. Now I'm gonna rinse my mouth out with soap. Cause I just feel so bad for having said that. And at the same time I don't give a shit. Because, well, it's me. If you've watched me for any length of time, you know I just don't give a shit. That's how it works. That is how it works, ladies and gentlemen. So yeah, make sure to subscribe, because I'm always like this. And I will continue to be like this. So I say, you know what? I don't feel like this anymore. But I don't see that happening anytime soon. To be fair, why would I give this up? I'm having the time of my freaking life. This is a hobby. This is a hobby. I mean, this is the best hobby ever. So smash the like button, subscribe for more videos very soon, and until next time, I'll see you all very soon. I hope you all have a very, very